everyone, my name is Mace and I hope you're doing absolutely fantastic. Today we're going to review this 1-200 scale Airbus A340-300 of Lufthansa in the Star Alliance livery made by JC Wings. So, let's see the pros and cons of this one. So here we are with the 1-200 scale A340-300 of JC Wings carrying the Star Alliance livery by Lufthansa. The aircraft is registered Delta Alpha India Golf November and is made in a duo production with Delta Alpha India Golf Victor, which is due to be released in the future. This model is released in September 2023 and is expected with retailers very soon. So we will look at the pros and cons of the JC Wings mold with the printing and with the execution of the livery. And I have to be honest that I didn't find a lot of things to which I can be critical about. The model itself is pretty good. There are problems with the tooling though, but very, very minor. Not as big as the in-flight 200 A340, which is, well, it's just bad. It doesn't really look like an A340, if I'm really honest. Yeah, that's a topic for another day. Today we will zoom in on this one. So, let's get started. And let's start with the printing details and delivery. So JC Wings made a very accurate representation of this A340-300. Not that it is a hard livery to execute, but there are certain things that you have to take into account whilst creating one. I think it's fair to say that JC Wings did do their studies on this Lufthansa aircraft. The window configuration is on point. The colors are very, very good, and I think they match with the actual aircraft. And small things like using customized placards on the doors and the cargo doors to match with the actual aircraft is outstanding. Something that I think a lot of collectors pay attention towards too. Couple of noteworthy details that I personally really like is the color of the Wi-Fi dome on top of the fuselage, which is actually a bit of a gray-brownish color. And JC Wings made that happen. They also added the spinners on the engine cones, and they have improved the nacelle detailing with a lot of panel lines on the engines. And last but not least, the shape of the cockpit window is more accurate. So if we look at the bottom of the aircraft, you can see some panel lines there. It has the dual beacon lights, traditionally with JC Wings, and they improved the shape of the landing light in the wing. The only minor issue that I find with the printing is that it looks like the door on the front is skewed a bit or angled a bit off, and that the windows in general are just a bit too high. Therefore, you have a lot of white space on the bottom, and also from the front you can see that the cockpit windows are just a bit, well, oddly shaped, or let's say they are just angled towards the top of the aircraft. But again, this is very, very minor, and only someone who's nitpicky like me will complain about that. I think in general the aircraft looks very, very good. The printing looks very nice, and it is of good quality as well. So if I had to give JC a grade for the printing, I would give them a 9 out of 10. I think the printing is done very, very good. Quality is crisp, colors are good, definitely a very accurate model. As with most JC Wings aircraft, the landing gear is detachable from the model, so you can choose whether you want to display your model with the gear down or with the gear up. The nose gear is also a steering nose wheel, and the main landing gear is able to tilt, which I think is a very nice feature if you would want to display your model on the stand as if it comes in for landing. Naturally, it comes also with the closed gear door configuration if you want to display your model as if it was flying. The only problem is, as you can see here, that the main landing gear door from the middle bogey is a bit too deep. But all of that is very minor, once again, and also fixable. Like, you can fix it yourself, that is not too much of a hassle. Also worth mentioning is that the A340 has a pretty good landing gear height. It doesn't stand too low on the ground or too high, which happens with other models in their range, But the A340 doesn't have this problem, which is quite nice. It looks quite good on the ground. All in all, very good landing gear on a very good model. Nothing to complain there. So all in all, I think this is a very, very decent A340, once again made by JC Wings. You don't see a lot of A340 releases from them, especially in 1 to 200 scale. But when they do it very good. This A340 I like. I think they put a lot of attention into the Star Alliance livery and in the overall details of the A340, which definitely shows on this aircraft model. For a price point of 125 euros, which is approximately $130, I believe, you're able to get your hands on one of these. They will be in retailers very soon. And for someone who collects legacy carriers or just quad jets, who knows, Star Alliance liveries, this is definitely a must-have. So that was my review. I really hoped you liked it. If you want me to do other reviews of other airplanes, let me know in the comments and make sure to subscribe for more content. Thank you so much for watching and take care.